Hey CNHBs, my name is Michelle Lee and I serve as the District Convention Chair for the 2019-2020 term. Even though District Convention 2020 was cancelled, we're still trying our best to make sure that everyone is getting the celebration that they deserve this year. Thank you for all of your hard work and dedication throughout the term. This term would not have been a great one if it weren't for all of you. We are going to be having a virtual awards ceremony to recognize everyone's hard work throughout the term. And that is all.
Hello, Key Clubbers, Kwanians, friends and family of our California-Nevada-Hawaii Key Club organization. My name is Douglas Chen. I am the district administrator for our Key Club organization, and I'd like to welcome all of you to our first ever end-of-the-year CNH District Awards and Recognition video stream. Thank you to all of the Key Clubbers and Kwanians who are a dedicated part of our Key Club organization. And please understand that the counseling of the district convention was a very difficult decision to make, but in retrospect, over the last month, we're certainly in the best interests of all of our Key Club members, our adult volunteers and Kwanians, and also our friends and family back home. During this unprecedented time of the COVID-19 pandemic, please be sure that you are doing all that you can to adhere to social distancing policies and helping to protect our communities from further spreading the virus. Once things do begin to normalize in typical Key Club fashion, please consider to doing service to our communities. There are certainly plenty of needs, from volunteering at the food bank or creating or sewing protective equipment and masks for our health providers. As usual, just think of what your community needs are and how your club and you can best support our communities. Enjoy this awards and recognition video stream, and I look forward to seeing you again at our next district event once things, once social distancing policies are lifted more and we're able to get back together again. Thank you and enjoy.
Hello, Key Clubbers. Over the course of the 2019 to the 2020 administrative year, Key Clubbers across California, Nevada, and Hawaii have contributed to making their communities a better place through each service project and fundraiser planned and attended. Through the recognition that the core of this organization is service, we will celebrate Key Clubbers, clubs, and advisors for all of their commendable attributes. Over the course of this term, the 2019 to 2020 District Member Recognition Committee has worked hard to prepare and plan for this session, so it is my honor to present to you the start of the award ceremony.
The Key Club Advisor is the foundation of the club. Beyond any successful Key Club, you will find a dedicated faculty or cohort advisor. The Advisor of the Year is an honor that is only bestowed upon those who have demonstrated countless hours of service and performed beyond the call of duty in helping their Key Club achieve their goals. This often means thankless hours as a chauffeur, as a chaperone, a mentor, a friend, or a counselor. Only one faculty and one Kuwant advisor have been selected from each division. The Division Judging Committee has selected the following advisors as faculty and Kuwant advisors of the year.
Induction into the Jack Luther Advisors Hall of Fame is the highest district honor for a Key Club advisor. This year's recipient proudly serves as a Kiwanis advisor for the two Key Clubs, her Kiwanis Club sponsors. This advisor is known to go above and beyond by assisting all the clubs in her division in whatever way necessary. Her untiring work ethic has ensured that all the clubs she assisted this year received a Distinguished or Diamond Distinguished Club Award. We would like to honor Kathy Shimizu, Baldwin and Kinke Kalike Key Club Kiwanis advisor and a longtime member of the Kiwanis Club of Kahului. Congratulations.
There is a saying which goes, time is money, but I believe that time is much more valuable. You can always earn more money, but you can never get more time. The position of a club treasurer is often overlooked and deemed as an easy title. However, this is not the case. A club treasurer must spend their time keeping meticulous records of financial transactions, educating members on the importance of dues, collecting and properly submitting those dues, organizing and promoting fundraisers, promoting scholarships, and working closely with advisors and school bookkeepers to properly deposit and withdraw funds. These are the basic duties of club treasurers, not the limitations. With passion, dedication, resilience, and time, club treasurers can go above and beyond to accomplish great feats. Thank you, CNH treasurers. In large parts to your efforts and time, we have reached our CNH district goal of raising $260,000 for the pediatric trauma program. Overall, we have raised $287,935.89, the greatest amount in the history of the CNH district. This would have not been possible without your hard work, and I would like to sincerely express my gratitude from the bottom of my heart. It's truly been an honor serving you all. The Cali-Nev-Ha district is so fortunate to have such assiduous club treasurers who truly dedicated their time to this term. The following individuals are being recognized as distinguished club treasurers. I see you dancing there, you go all night long, you ain't watching no one else, girl, in your zone.
The club secretary is crucial for this organization to prosper. They are the ties between the officer board and members and keep the club organized. It is through the hard work and dedication of club secretaries in CNH that our district is able to report phenomenal hours to international. Completing the monthly report form is not the only duty of a club secretary. They must compile directories, create meeting minutes, keep track of hours, and above all, commit their time to service throughout the year. To say that the club secretary is the backbone of the club is truly an understatement. Thank you, Cali-Nev-Ha secretaries. Your unwavering service and leadership have truly made this organization amazing. Let us take a moment to recognize all club secretaries. CNH has a great number of outstanding secretaries, however, the following have truly exceeded expectations and are being recognized as distinguished. I want to strike the match. Are you with nobody else, girl? Let me know. Cause I love the way you are.
When asked to describe this club position, every vice president would have something different to say. Whether it's being the right hand of the club president, overseeing club's committees, planning service products for the club, or doing anything and everything that the club needs of them, the vice president is an essential role in every club.
This year, several vice presidents have gone above and beyond, defining the role of a vice president in their own unique way. They have devoted countless hours to their home club and served this organization with outstanding dedication. Today, we are recognizing the following vice club presidents as distinguished. But you won't let down your guard. And I need you
to just open up for tonight. Without the hundreds of club presidents in this district, CNH should be nowhere as great as it is right now. Each club president serves as the foundation of its organization, the members, and each individual club. The list of duties is endless, whether it be communicating with their Kiwanis, running club meetings, representing their club on the division level, organizing projects and activities for the club on the club, division, district, and international level, motivating their members, and in general, ensuring that the Key Club year runs smoothly.
Each club president has dedicated a year of their life, days of free time, and hours of sleep. Each club president has displayed organization, outstanding character, patience, spirit, enthusiasm, love, dedication, and a can-do attitude that is to be respected. However, the following have truly exceeded all expectations and are being recognized as Dr. Har's Distinguished Presidents.
The most effective marketing strategies are those that are targeted toward a specific audience, focus on key benefits based on the audience's point of view and interests, and deliver it at appropriate times when the audience is most likely to be attentive and interested in the message being delivered. There are several marketing strategies a club may utilize to attract new members and maintain effective communication throughout the year, including Key Club gear, posters, videos, and websites. After continuously working hard to keep their website updated, the following club editors are being recognized for having distinguished websites.
Newsletters are another effective way of showcasing the past and the future activities of clubs and divisions. Showcasing a variation of members and new updates every month after spending hours creating their newsletters, the following club editors are being recognized for publishing distinguished club newsletters. The following division news editors are being recognized for publishing distinguished division newsletters.
Another way to both market your club and reflect on a year of service, leadership, and family is to create a scrapbook. Clubs may submit a year in review in a digital, traditional, and non-traditional format. The traditional and non-traditional formats are recognized on the district and international level. The following club is being recognized for creating a distinguished digital traditional year in review submission.
Categories designated for the single service contest: bronze, silver, gold, and platinum, that correlates with the club's membership size. The bronze level includes clubs with 35 dues paid members or less, silver is 36 to 60 dues paid members, and gold is 61 to 85 dues paid members, and platinum is 86 members or more. This year, the following club is being recognized in the bronze category for a distinguished single service project. It's a fantasy waiting
here. Hello, I'm Pete Ballew, Special Assistant to the District Administrator and also known as the Backstage Voice. It is a great honor to be with you today. It was at the 60th Annual Cali-Nev-Ha Kiwanis District Convention that a resolution was presented at the House of Delegates to create the Sponsored Youth Scholarship Fund. The guidance, vision, and passion of the 1979-1980 District Governor, Dr. Ken Forer, and Ted Gibbs, one of his Lieutenant Governors, is what enables us to be here today to present these scholarships to the future leaders of our communities. Congratulations to the recipients of the $1,000 Kenneth C. Forer MD Memorial Scholarship: Elaine May Abitayo, Birmingham Charter; Robert Avila, Herbert Hoover; Randy Bach, Mount Carmel; Manit Chahal, Antelope; Justin Chong, Herbert Hoover; Alyssa Contreras, San Lorenzo; Karina Cook, Waiakea; Melinda Dow, Monterey Trail; Katrina Doe, Franklin; Katie Huang, Lowell; Myrna Issa, Santana; Heather Jung, Herbert Hoover; Jennifer Kamimura, Hilo; Andrea Lee, Franklin; Ching Ying Lee, Edgewood; Dennis Lee, Mount Carmel; May Lin, Granite Bay; Liliana Lojudis, Notre Dame Belmont; Naya Lunny, Newberry Park; Amanda Mackemson, Taft; Mary Minasian, Herbert Hoover; Caitlin Navarro, Southwest CTA; Julian Nelson Longacre, Hilo; Vianda Nguyen, Benjamin Holt; Josie Nye, Gretchen Whitney; Dalina Ong, Dozier Libby; Kennedy Perry, Hemet; Danielle Fan, Branham; Jordan Lee Picadura, Hawaii Technology Academy; Alexis Sanchez, Cloverdale; Janet Tang, Duarte; Brenda Tran, San Marcos; Juliana Tran, American Canyon; William Trong, Glen A. Wilson; Ivy V, Western; Edward Vo, Westminster; Karen Vo, Middle College; Michelle Wang, Gabrielino, Ivan Yao, Concord, and Chofan Yu, Middle College. The Kiwanis Cali-Nev-Ha Foundation Board has permanently designated certain named scholarships to honor the generosity of those donors who have made a significant donation to the foundation or individuals from whom memorial gifts were made to the foundation. Tonight, I am pleased to present our named scholarships. Receiving the Kiwanis Club of Palo Alto Scholarship in the amount of $1,000 is Paula Toledo Ortega from Cloverdale Key Club. Receiving the Kiwanis Club of Glendale Scholarship in the amount of $1,250 is Andrea Lee from Clovis North Key Club. Past Foundation President Lainey Wheeler and her husband Dave made a generous donation to our foundation, allowing us to present a scholarship in the amount of $1,500 this year to Katie Hahn of Benicia Key Club. Foundation Secretary Treasurer Pete Horton and his wife Diana gifted to the foundation a generous sum, allowing us to present this year's scholarship in the amount of $1,500 to Yolanda Mai from Del Norte Key Club. The family of Irvin C. Chapman made a generous gift to the foundation, allowing us to present this scholarship in the amount of $1,500 to Diego Solorio from Godinez Key Club. Past Key Club District Administrator Jack Luther gifted to the foundation a generous sum, which has allowed us to present this year's scholarship in the amount of $1,500 to Emily Chow from the Franklin Key Club. Past Foundation President Richard Olmsted and his wife Cheryl made a generous gift to the foundation, which allows us to present this $1,500 scholarship to Miguel Gonzalez from Cloverdale Key Club. The Howe Scholarship is named for past Foundation Board Director John Howe and his wife Sue. This year, the Howe Scholarship in the amount of $1,500 is being awarded to Rebecca Pan from Los Altos Key Club. Past Foundation President Russ Kiner and his wife Jamie made a generous donation. This year, the Kiner Scholarship in the amount of $1,750 is being awarded to Queenie Lamb from South San Francisco High Key Club. Jay and Diane Schultz made a generous gift to the foundation in memory of their daughter, Julie Dieguez, allowing us to award the $1,750 scholarship to Joshua James Garcia from Gretchen Whitney High School Key Club. In memory of former Foundation Director Richard K. Minatoya, the Foundation established the Richard K. Minatoya Memorial Scholarship. The inaugural scholarship in the amount of $1,750 is being awarded to Lawrence Gerald Gita from Farrington High School Key Club. The Muggleberg Memorial Scholarship is named for past Kiwanis District Governor Glenn E. Muggleberg and his wife Millie. This year, the Muggleberg Scholarship is in the amount of $2,250, which I am pleased to present to Crezia Basilio of Richard Gar Key Club. The Prada Scholarship is a matching fund scholarship established by past district administrator and past Kiwanis District Governor Richard Prada. This year, the Prada Scholarship in the amount of $2,500 is being awarded to Nathan Nguyen of Upland Key Club. The Kiwanis International Children's Fund provides short-term grants to qualifying Kiwanis districts through their district grant program. This year, Cali-Nev-Ha received two $4,500 grants to be distributed as one-time scholarships. I am pleased to present the Kiwanis International grant of $4,500 each to Ali Al-Salim from Western Key Club and Kainalu Yoshida from King Kekiolaki Key Club. In 1996, past District Lieutenant Governor Les McElwain approached the foundation to propose the creation of a scholarship in memory of his wife, Loretta Barksdale McElwain. The scholarship was awarded for the first time in 1997. The Loretta Barksdale McElwain Scholarship is now the largest award given by the foundation to a high school senior who is a member of Key Club or Kiwins. This year, a member of Key Club will be the recipient of that scholarship in the amount of $15,870. The 2020 Loretta Barksdale McElwain Scholarship is being awarded to Nathaniel Davila of John Marshall High School Key Club. Congratulations to all scholarship recipients, and a great big thank you to the Cali-Nev-Ha Foundation Board of Directors and Officers.
General members are what make up this organization. Through the Member Recognition Program, members across the district are being recognized for their participation in service, leadership, and fellowship. This year, there were 948 members to have qualified for the four levels of recognition. The four levels are bronze, silver, gold, and platinum. All members who have earned and filed for this recognition will be listed on the B list on screen.
guess I'll be the first to say it. I haven't felt this good in a while. You tell me I'm the only one that they would all like.
In addition, we would like to grant extra recognition for 65 members who qualified for the platinum level, which entails a minimum of 200 hours served along with 10 additional requirements fulfilled. Please congratulate the 2019 to 2020 MRP Platinum winners. But you're the only one that kept me alive. You were the only one. You were the only one that kept me alive. You were the only one.
The next award will recognize those who have gone above and beyond the call of duty. To be eligible to apply for the Key Club Distinguished Member of the Year Award, each applicant must have performed a minimum of 50 service hours for the current Key Club year, not hold an elected position at the club, division, district, or international level, and meet a number of other requirements. In today's competitive society, it is extremely difficult to find an individual with true selfless passion and devotion to a nonprofit organization. While others join as many clubs as possible to enhance their resumes, there are a few who choose to join a club with the purpose of making a difference. Being an active member who is willing to assist wherever needed, these individuals exemplify the Key Club core values. Well-respected and admired by fellow members, officers, and advisors, these individuals are considered model club members who lead by example.
The Sandy Ninninger Award is the highest award presented to a Key Club member that is recognized on the Key Club international level. This award is named after Key Club member and Army Lieutenant Alexander Sandy Ninninger, who took service and sacrifice to the highest level during World War II. This year's recipient exhibits the same work ethic as Sandy Ninninger. This member has dedicated countless hours to his community, his club, his division, our district, in our international organization. Identified by his colleagues as a role model and humble leader, performing all duties to the best of his ability, he motivates others to get involved and be recognized for their service. This year's recipient of the Sandy Ninninger Award is someone who has served our district with the inspirational purpose of encouraging and ensuring the recognition of clubs, members, and divisions for their service. Please help me congratulate from... Fear can grip me
at night. All Key Clubs need to be recognized for what they do, but the following clubs stand out most specifically for achieving Distinguished or Diamond Distinguished status. Distinguished Club is an honor given to a club that exceeds 148 points in an Annual Achievement Report or AAR score, and Diamond Distinguished Club is only given to those clubs with over 178 points. These points signify that all members of the club are active servants in the community and are interconnected with members of the Kwan's family. Please help me congratulate the following Distinguished Clubs. Well, somehow, somewhere you make me believe I could see it in your eyes. So take me. Please help me congratulate the following Diamond Distinguished Clubs. This award goes to the division that continually seeks improvement and always pushes the boundaries. This division didn't just meet expectations, but instead went above and beyond in order to leave a lasting legacy that will provide for its continual growth and development in the coming years. The Most Improved Division Award goes to the division who has reflected the greatest amount of all-around growth when comparing its past year to its current year. It is not only the numbers and data that are being considered, but a variety of all other factors as well. It is with great pride and pleasure that I present the Most Improved Division Award to Division 23 for all that they have achieved in just 1 year. With 76 divisions in the Cali-Nev-Ha Key Club District, this award goes to the division that has shown overall excellence in all aspects of the division. Throughout this year, this division has worked to excel in every possible way: service, membership recruitment, fundraising, leadership, and so much more. This division has served a collective total of over 23,000 hours, amounting to 50.6 hours per member, with all clubs reaching distinguished or diamond distinguished status. The clubs within this division have all set the example to continue serving, participating in any way possible, even when they may be located on three separate islands. I am confident that they will only continue to pursue nothing less than success in the year ahead. Please join me in congratulating Division 22 Mackay for the overall Division Excellence Award. The Robert F. Lucas Outstanding Lieutenant Governor Award strives to recognize lieutenant governors across our great organization who have shown extraordinary leadership and service to those around them. Lieutenant governors across the globe aim to support and grow the local clubs in their respective division while also acting as a liaison between the district and club levels. The roles of a lieutenant governor is not an easy one, and I am honored to recognize the following lieutenant governors for their efforts during this term. Please help me congratulate the following Robert F. Lucas Outstanding Lieutenant Governors. I won't lie and fear no more. I hope you realize you kept me alive. Oh. Being Lieutenant Governor is in no way an effortless role. From planning division-wide events to reporting on the number of hours served by each member of the division each month to the district, Lieutenant Governors are tasked with a multitude of duties to ensure that they are providing the best experience for the members that they serve. Lieutenant Governors in the California Nevada Hawaii District are known for being impeccable at what they do. And I can say with absolute honesty that the 2019-2020 Lieutenant Governors have proven time and time again just how incredible the CNH District really is. The title of Distinguished is awarded to Lieutenant Governors that have gone above and beyond their call of duty. They have continuously pushed for only the best, and even if in the face of failure, they were able to get up and continue trying to serve you at the best of their abilities. Their unwavering service and commitment to the membership has not gone unnoticed. After reading through thousands of pages from their distinguished binders, these individuals were identified as Distinguished Lieutenant Governor for all of their hard work, dedication, reflection, and overall outstanding passion for service. Thank you all for all that you've done throughout your term. Please help me congratulate the following Distinguished Lieutenant Governors.
As a Key Club District Administrator, I have the privilege of recognizing individuals who have made a significant contribution to our CNH Key Club District, as well as to myself as a Key Club District Administrator. This year, I have the distinct pleasure of recognizing two individuals with the District Administrator Award. The first individual that I want to recognize is a Kwanian who's spent decades serving our Key Club organization. In fact, back in the days when I was in Key Club, which was many, many years ago, he was a region advisor and helped provide me mentoring and guidance and advice, which continued to be so during the days when I was in college in Circle K. And then later when I became a Kwanian and became part of the Key Club committee, adult committee region advisor myself, I was serving alongside with him, serving our Key Club organization. The person I'm speaking of is no other than Mr. Bruce Hennings, our director of service leadership programs. My terms as a district administrator for the last several years, Mr. Hennings has been my bedrock, ensuring that I keep on top of things, and he helps to ensure that our Key Club district runs smoothly and efficiently. Some of you may not be aware, but Mr. Hennings is planning to retire this September. So this would have been his last Key Club district convention, serving as, you know, the director of service leadership programs. So I definitely wanted to make sure that he is recognized with the District Administrator's Award as a culmination of all of his dedication and service to the CNH Key Club organization. Bruce Hennings, thank you so much. And everyone, please join me in recognizing and recognition of Mr. Bruce Hennings for his dedication to Key Club with the District Administrator's Award. The second person I'd like to recognize with the District Administrator's Award is an individual who was part of our K family organization back in high school herself when she was in, back then called Kiwanettes, now called Kiwins. I met this person in Circle K, and she later agreed to become my wife. So I'd like to recognize with the District Administrator Award my wife, Cindy Jin. Serving as District Administrator, as you can imagine, is a huge commitment, both in time and resources, and she's been there for me for all the times when I had to travel away from home, serving as administrator, all the times when I've been on conference calls and meetings, or working with the student leaders in helping to guide them through their terms as student leaders in our Key Club organization. Oftentimes, she's been there at conventions and other district events and supportive of us and our organization as, well, she's a nurse, so at times she's had to serve in that capacity if there's ever been a medical need. Not something that she ever looked forward to, but something that she knew that she could contribute to the organization. But fundamentally, she's also been my bedrock as a district administrator, and I wanted to be sure that she gets recognized with the District Administrator's Award. So, Cindy, thank you for all that you do to allow me to serve and function as a Key Club District Administrator. Please join me in recognizing my wife, Cindy. Thank you so much. Again, thank you to Mr. Bruce Hennings and to my wife, Cindy Jin. Thank you.
We have now come to the end of the award ceremony. I would like to take this moment to say thank you to each advisor, general member, and officer who has contributed to the success of our wonderful California-Nevada-Hawaii district. Congratulations to every award recipient for the 2019 to 2020 term, and I hope that you all continue to do work worthy of being recognized and understand that every small act you do makes a difference. Every winner will be receiving a certificate, and all distinguished recipients will be receiving a medal or plaque, which will be delivered to all winners.
Now introducing your 2020-2021 Executive Board.
What's buzzing, bees? My name is Daniel Min, and I'm proud to say that I'll be serving you as your next district governor. I know that throughout this next term, we're going to be accomplishing huge things together, and I can't wait to be a part of that ride with you all. So I hope to see you all again soon, bees. Thank you.
What's poppin', CNH? My name is Grace Yip, and I'm so excited to be serving as your next district secretary for the 2020 to 2021 term. I'm so excited to see what is in store for us this term, and I hope to see you all soon. Bye.
What's poppin' CNH? I'm Yana Sa, and I'm here to serve you all as the next district treasurer. I can't wait to meet all of you guys and work with you guys throughout the next term. Thank you!
Thank you so much for watching this awards video. I know that it was disappointing that we couldn't celebrate our achievements together this year at the district convention, and I hope that watching this video with your friends and club members fills some of those empty spaces. And congratulations to all the award winners! As we move into the next term now, please remember to remain a servant leader wherever you are and hold on to the core values of leadership, inclusiveness, character building, and caring. As we face challenges harder than ever, Let's come together metaphorically and work on continuing this legacy. Thank you everyone, and please stay home and stay safe.